Okay, good morning. So, we'll continue with our discussion on solution to the RTE. If you recall, we started with the RTE, okay, and then these properties could be a function of x, y, z directions. Then it becomes three dimensional and it becomes very difficult. All these properties are also varying with x, y, z, then it is very bad, okay. So, we okay, so this plane parallel approximation makes everything a function of one of z only, okay. And then we talked about fluxes. What is the difference between flux and intensity? Then you can talk about some Q. This is the root, right? That capital Q is very much used in heat transfer for conduction, convection, radiation. So, we start from I, we can go to F, but F is qualified by F nu or F lambda, okay, it is spectral flux. Then the spectral flux has got watts per meter square per micrometer. You can integrate from lambda 1 to lambda 2, which is like this. Okay. So, you can do it numerical integration, but that F lambda is I lambda cos theta, and I lambda is treacherous, C1 lambda to the power of minus 5 divided by e to the power of C2 by lambda t minus 1. You have to integrate, it is not directly integrable, therefore, you will have to use numerical techniques, because F is coming from I, I itself is coming from Planck's distribution, is it okay? Now, we also looked at this one, right? What is that? The arrow mark? This is upward, correct? Upward flux. Wait, what is the funda of this? Suppose you take something like this layer. From the bottom it can go to the top within a layer, from the top it can go to the bottom, from the top it can go to somewhere else, okay. It can also receive from here, it can also receive from here, okay. I think that was represented, isn't it? So, are you able to see? Apart, it is not only the absorption, it is also the emission, okay. So, we are looking at layer wise. So, we are looking at what is happening to a particular layer. Why are we interested in all this layer wise this thing and so on? We want to be able to calculate what is the time rate of change of temperature across various layers in the atmosphere. This will lead us to help us to find out the stability of the atmosphere and this thing and radiative budget calculations. It also useful in forecasting and so on. Okay. Now, where did we stop? All right. So, did we stop here? Is it right? Okay. What is this? Is there an equation number for this? Last class? No. Why are many people absent? They went home, is it? Okay. Was there a number for this? No number. Okay. What does that equation give you? What is the use of this equation? Forget the mathematical development. What do you understand from this equation? Last week, who asked me a doubt? Tau mu of nu 1. It's okay. Okay, let's get back to this. What does that equation give you? If I know what I nu is, okay, and if I put that mu is cos theta, again, if I am able to integrate it either analytically or numerically, I will be able to get the flux. So, from intensity, I will be able to get the flux. This is the intensity flux relationship equation. Okay, that I nu itself has to come from what? Not only Planck's law, I knew if it is just one layer of, if it is just one atmospheric layer, who is free? Suppose this is the cell phone and this is your I knew, then there is no problem at all. But suppose this cell phone is a layer in the atmosphere, there are layers above it and layers below it. Solar radiation is coming in, Earth's infrared radiation is coming up. This fellow himself will re-radiate infrared radiation. Therefore, how do you solve it? It is not a hopeless case. To solve it, you have to solve dI lambda by dS plus kappa lambda I lambda is equal to whatever. For that, you need to know that kappa lambda or kappa nu. So, if you solve that equation of transfer, you will be able to get that value of I nu. If you shove it in into this, you will be able to get that f of nu. Then, if you have an instrument which will detect this radiation between nu to nu plus d nu, then you put it into that equation, in this equation, and get so many watts per meter square. This will be the watts per meter square captured by the sensor which you have placed above the satellite. This can be a designated frequencies which will be decided by the atmospheric scientists and the remote sensing people together after looking at the electromagnetic spectrum and how the radiation is absorbed at the top of the atmosphere and at the ground, where there are absorption bands, where are the transmission bands. Based on this, we will have a multi-channel or a multi-spectral infrared sounder, infrared imager, microwave sounder, microwave imager and so on, with which we will be able to what is called reconstruct the vertical profile of the atmosphere. That means what? We should be able to reconstruct the temperature and humidity profile without launching balloons all over the place. Or in the absence of this, we will report only climatological data. Generally in Chennai in November, temperature from 0 to this thing 10 kilometers will be like this. If you do not know anything, you will say that. Next step is to have a radio sonde. But that radio sonde only based on Meenambakkam and Nungambakkam, you cannot say that the same thing will be valid in Anna Nagar or Besant Nagar or OMR or whatever. If you have a high resolution satellite, then on a 2 kilometer by 2 kilometer, 3 kilometer by 3 kilometer, you can say it with confidence. That is what satellite meteorology has achieved. So, meteorology need not be only making measurements on the playground or making measurements in the ground, having rain gauges, having balloons. Meteorology can also be done by having satellites, that is satellite meteorology. Meteorology can also be done by cracking the CFD problem in the atmosphere or the radiation problem in the atmosphere, there can be computational meteorology or numerical weather modeling. Okay. In that numerical weather modeling, it is predominantly the winds and this thing and moisture and energy and all these which are included, all these which are considered, but radiation will come as a source term, just like your Laplace equation. You remember your Laplace equation? So, I am digressing quite a bit. Okay, if you want to solve the conduction equation, 100 degree centigrade, 30 degree centigrade, 30 degree centigrade, 30 degree centigrade. This can also electrical engineers, who are the electrical engineers here? Okay, so you, it can also be del square phi equal to 0, where phi is your potential, electric potential. It can civil engineers, it can also be the stream function, or who are the civil engineers here? It can also be the stream function and this thing, underwater seepage problem and all that, porous media, all the, okay. So, it can be anything. Now, the equation is del square T equal to 0. If I have a volumetric heat generation which can occur because of a biological reaction or because of an exothermic reaction or because heat is generated by nuclear fuel rod, this equation will get converted to del square T plus QV by K equal to 0, where K is the thermal conductivity of the medium and QV is the volumetric heat generation rate. Likewise, so this is the energy equation for this problem. The energy equation for the atmosphere will be U dou T by dou X plus V dou T by dou A plus W dou T by dou Z equal to all those things, which is coming from your Navier-Stokes equation. In that equation, the source term, you can add the radiation term as a source term. So, if you want to calculate the source term, you have to solve the equation of transfer. That is the radiation CFD coupling. So, the numerical weather prediction is basically the CFD applied to the atmosphere. Why can't we just use Fluent? Fluent is not capable of handling that because the coordinate system is different versus a spherical coordinate system. We use what is called the Mercator projection and so on. The Earth is also not a perfect sphere. So, we have to do some modification. And this fellow is also rotating. Once he is rotating, you have to take care of the Coriolis component of the Earth's rotation, which will be another term in the momentum equations and so on. Then you add these source terms and then you are done. So, it is very, very difficult. If you start programming it, you will not finish your PhD. So, many people have done it and the body of literature is available and community software are available. So, these are numerical NWP models, numerical weather prediction models. You would understand one of these models, pick them up and start solving. The models are at various scales. There can be a model which can solve at 400 kilometer by 400 kilometer resolution, which will be the global model. Or you can have a mesoscale or regional model where you solve only over the Bay of Bengal or the Arabian Sea or the Indian subcontinent, for which you require boundary conditions. Who will give you boundary conditions? Boundary conditions have to be updated with time. So, there is a global model which is always running. The Yankees are running, the Americans are running. So, on a 400 by 400. So, on your domain, whatever is the result for the 400 by 400, dynamically once in 6 hours, take that boundary condition and start with some initial condition and do your local stuff. And you can add your own masala by putting your own model for Indian monsoon, this, that and run. And then you keep on reducing the domain. If you are able to run it on a 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer, your Param or Virgo or supercomputer you run. And then you validate it with your radio sounding and this thing. And one cyclone, past cyclone, you prove that your model is working well. Oh, I have now cracked the problem of cyclone. From tomorrow onwards, if any cyclone is formed 72 hours in advance or 48 hours in advance, I can predict it. It's a 5-minute course on numerical weather prediction. Okay? For the numerical weather prediction, the source term radiation is important. Radiation is important separately without numerical weather prediction because from satellite data we will know whether forests have degraded, whether there is afforestation or deforestation, whether in a particular place there is a fire. Okay? Civil engineers, they want to use land use, habitation, so many things can be studied using this. Okay? And you can reconstruct the profile of the atmosphere and so on. And you can see this over 30 or 40 years or 50 years and look at climate change. Climate change cannot be studied with the satellite data for 5 years. So, now satellite data is available for 30, 40 years. People are saying we can make some inroads into this because climate means we have to look at hundreds of years, decadal variation, minimum decadal variation, century wise variation, epochal variation and so on. Are you getting the point? So, this is not a 2-minute course on climate science, which will come Friday. We will look at the climate change. Now, this equation is clear. It gives the relationship between intensity and. Now, this is hard to integrate. This is hard to integrate even though an expression for I nu is available. This mu d mu, because this I nu you know some e to the power of minus will come. For the case of pure absorption, that e to the power of minus kappa lambda is coming, tau nu is coming, which is the Beer's law, correct? Therefore, if you have e to the power of minus into cos theta d of cos theta, that is actually cos theta sin theta d theta d phi. The d phi I have integrated and put taken the t 2 pi out. That's why the double integral has become a single integral. How many of you did not recognize that? So everybody is with me. The solid angle is double integral. The d phi 2 pi we have taken out. So we made it a single integral. 0 to pi by 2, I made it 0 to 1. Now, cos theta is mu. Sin theta is that d mu and then minus, minus 0, 1, 1, 0, all those things we have done. Now I will, we have to introduce a term called flux transmissivity. So let us do a small excursion. So a little bit of digression. So this is Beer's law. Correct? So tau lambda equal to what is the intensity of I lambda after it has travelled through a distance of S compared to the tau, what is I lambda after the I lambda naught has travelled through a distance of S as opposed to the I lambda when it has not travelled through any distance of S equal to 0 which corresponds to I lambda naught. So this is this tau lambda is called the flux transmissivity and it is always expected to be for a pure absorbing case this value will be. First of all, is it dimensional or dimensionless? Dimensionless. It has a value between? It absorbs everything. What is the value then? 0. It allows everything? 1. Very good. So, these are the asymptotic limits. So, the tau lambda is called the flux transmissivity. What is the value from this equation? What is the expression? E to the power of? Very good. Oh, that so there is a conflict, okay, T lambda, tau lambda is appearing on the left side, right side, okay, there is issue with that, okay, Chaitanya, you are happy, so you, or you put tau dash or something, point is made, right, Similarly, suppose we define tau of nu flux transmissivity I define something like this. So it is hard to, it's confusing. This one make it tau mu. Viswajit, not following. Why am I putting this 2 to the power of? Because I expect that when I nu, when I simplify that e to the power of minus term will come inside that. All right. That is why I am doing this. So, I say that I define an equivalent flux transmissivity, I define such a way that this whole expression can be replaced by e to the power of minus tau mu tau nu by mu bar, where mu bar is an average zenith angle, and the value of this expression or the intensity at this average zenith angle is representative of the integral of 2 of 0 to 1 mu d mu and all that. Are you getting the point? Very good. How many of you not understood anything? What? Yeah, this you can say. Correct. Okay, I will use the cell phone again. Okay, let us solve a heat transfer problem. This, my hand is the base. It is generating heat 100 degrees centigrade here. I want to cool it. This, assume that the cell phone is a metal. I attach it. Like this, I attach several fins. That means it will take the heat from this metal, then it will cool. Surface area is increased. Once you have surface area, why do you do that for coffee and tea? The surface area is increased more than it is just in the, have you seen? Okay, so here too the surface area is increased. Okay, all right. Now the temperature will decrease from here to here. That means from here it is 100 degrees, from here to here it will decrease. But the temperature may also change in this direction. Okay, now what I am saying is, in the other direction, if in the fin, in this direction it is decreasing like this. Okay, in this direction. In this direction, suppose it is varying like this. What I am trying to say is, I have to measure the temperatures. I am already putting some thermocouples and measuring. It will be a very costly affair for me to put for several rows across the other direction also, and then take a global average. What I will say is, I will numerically integrate the temperature at any section x in the direction, if this is y, in this direction I will integrate, and then I will find out here at what height the local temperature is very close to the average temperature in that direction. Then I will use only, so I will put, instead of putting thermocouples in the middle, I will put thermocouples at that height where the local temperature is representative of the average in the other direction. Like that, is there average zenith angle? That is the point. Is now it's clear? Okay. That average zenith angle is 53 degrees. 1 by mu bar is secant 53. What is secant 53? Don't say 1 by cos 53. I want the value. There are two people, Ram and Shyam. Ram is asked, where is your house? My house is next to Shyam. Shyam, where is your house? Next to Ram. Then how do you solve the problem? What are your coordinates? You have to fix the coordinates, right? How can you measure the speed of the train when you are inside the train? Don't say, sir, I will look at some girls, mile post, go. I mean, you have to be an observer standing outside, isn't it? What do you say, Sujit? Okay. Now, let us not get into philosophy. So, the next logical question, how do you study the mind? If you are both the observed and the observer. Okay, this will be edited. Or let it be. It's okay, right? So, now, this 1 by mu bar secant, 1 by mu bar is secant 53 is 1.66. In other words, the flux transmissivity of a layer, please write down this. In other words, you need not write. The flux transmissivity of a layer is equivalent to equivalent to the intensity of a parallel beam of radiation which is transmitted when passing through the medium. Intensity of radiation which is transmitted when passing through the medium with the zenith angle of 53 degrees. Okay. This 1 by mu bar in radiative heat transfer is frequently referred to as the diffusivity factor. Maybe I think somebody who studied solar radiation, they might have given diffusivity factor. Professor Srinivas Reddy must have taught you. You vaguely remember? Diffusivity factor is that 1.66 takes care of the directional effect. Okay. So, applying the concept of diffusivity factor, applying this concept, we can simplify that. Please note there is one 2 inside this, there is one 2 inside, so there is one 2 here, so that has to be taken care of. So is it okay? Very good. What is the simplification we have done? You tell me what the value of I nu is, I will give you the value of F nu approximately by using the secant 53. What is that I nu itself? It has to be, the equation of transfer has to be solved. Rohan, is it clear? Okay. So, this is the progress we have achieved so far. All right. Now, I told you with this you can integrate over the wave number. Integrate over the wave number means we integrate over a wavelength interval. Why do you want over a wavelength interval? I gave you the story of remote sensing where you want to integrate over some channels, 10.5 micrometer to 10.8 micrometer, 6.7 micrometer to 6.8 micrometer, and you design a sensor. No sensor can be designed for capturing only at 6.77 micrometer, and 6.76 it will be 0, 6.78 it will be 0, it won't be like this. So, there will be a, I told you, SRF. Spectral response function, we saw about Lorentz broadening and pressure broadening, all the stories we have already seen. Okay. Now, we have to solve a very important problem in the atmospheric radiation, how to get the vertical profiles of the radiative heating rate with this development. Okay. So, if you take a layer of the atmosphere, the rate of change of this will be equal to correct? You can take it as F. F is let us call it 1. What is rho? Density of the air. Cp is the specific heat capacity of the air. So, now we can find out what is the rate of change of temperature with respect to time for a unit wavelength interval or a unit wave number interval. Sir, what are you doing? Good question. Okay, what I am doing is like this. Atmosphere is like this. I am taking a particular layer. In a particular layer, I am trying to find out what is the rate of change of temperature with time. Like that, if I do it for all the layers, I can get the vertical profile of the radiative heating rate. Then I can figure out what is this profile separately for various constituents. I can do for carbon dioxide, for water vapor, for ozone and so on. Separately for various wavelengths I can do, short wave, long wave, then I can integrate and find out over overall part of the spectrum. Finally, you will realize that the temperature will decrease in the troposphere. Otherwise, if all these calculations will be wrong, the temperature will decrease in the troposphere and the atmosphere has to be in radiative equilibrium in the which portion of the atmosphere? Temperature does not decrease with for at least some portion. Why is it called stratosphere? There is no temperature change for some region. In that region, it has to be radiatively, it has to be at radiative equilibrium. What does it mean? F up will be equal to F down. If F up is not equal to F down, the temperature will change depending on which is more powerful, going out or incoming. Okay, this is the problem we are going to solve. So, all these developments critically hinge on your ability to get F. F is already related to I. I comes from the equation of transfer. Now, we can take one layer, and if you are working only in the infrared part of the spectrum, we are going to simplify that I nu. Once you simplify that I nu, we have a simple expression. What is this? This is a very simplified approach to solve this problem. Or you can say, to hell with all this, for every nu, I will calculate the kappa nu and this thing, and I use the most powerful supercomputer and solve it. That is also okay. But we are now trying to see, just like lumped capacitance method, where we say the whole body is at one temperature. Like that, we are trying to do a simplified treatment. But please remember that even this simplified treatment gives a reasonable accuracy to the heating rate problem in the atmosphere. Okay, all right. Now, what is the next step? Now I have to do the. I already drew this, right? So, if it is one layer, some radiation is going to outer space from this. So, the next layer. Now, there is something incoming to this. From bottom, something is going up and it can also do something to the other layers. So, now, sir, why are you considering long wave? I am considering long wave to kick the solar radiation out. Because I am doing only infrared remote sensing. We derived the equation of transfer for the infrared. So, in infrared part of the spectrum, the contribution by solar radiation is very less, correct? That we have already seen. Okay. So, it is a cooling problem for every layer. It is a cooling, we can consider it as a cooling problem. And we simplify all this and say there is only one flux going outside. So, if you have this simplification, then what happens? So, dT by equal to d by dz of great, there will be mu, right? Mu d mu. Don't get worried too much. I wrote that, I kept the DT by DT. I kept by DT by D tau time. I took the rho Cp outside, I retained the minus. I took the D by DZ. Then I wrote the expression for F. Instead of 2 pi, suddenly I made it 4 pi because I am considering the full sphere. You can have consideration for that layer, something can be from the top, something can be from the bottom also. Is it okay? Now, okay, now omega I nu into mu is basically I nu into cos theta, that is for the flux to this thing. Then d omega solid angle will be there. Between 3 and 4 I did something. What? Yeah, I swapped the places of derivative, the integral and the derivative, that is the Leibniz rule. Correct? I used the Leibniz rule, and one more thing I did. I kicked the mu out because I now considered S equal to by mu. I did many things. Okay? Therefore, -1 to di nu by ds equal to kappa nu, nu I nu minus b nu, that is coming from the radial equation of transfer. Then I did something, omega consists of cos theta, sin theta, d theta, d phi, or sin theta, d theta, d phi. The d phi if I integrate, I can take out the some 2 pi out. Then what I did was that rho can be taken out. So the rho will get cancelled. Then that cos theta I put it as sin theta, I can put it as d of cos theta. D mu, I changed all this. All right. Don't ask me why 4 is not coming, you check out the 2 is correct. Okay. So, minus 2 pi by Cp. Cp is coming, right? Okay, here I am using this approximation. Watch this carefully, otherwise you will forget, you will lose track of this. There are so many exchanges which are taking place. Finally, we can make an approximation that all these internal exchanges are cancelling. From this layer, only there is an outward flux which is going out, which is basically dependent only on the emission. Therefore, in the I nu minus B nu, this I nu can be completely cancelled because I nu coming in is equal to the I nu going out. But it's a B nu is there because by virtue of its temperature being greater than 0 Kelvin, that will exist. So that minus B nu will come, and then this is very nice. That is 0 to 1 e to the power of minus tau nu d mu. Just now we saw it can be replaced by the flux transmissivity, which is the secant 53. Okay. So, if it is like this, then this is equal to you can check it with Excel. So for every layer, for every frequency or wave number, if you know what the kappa nu is, if you know the temperature, okay, you can get B nu. You know this is not nu, it is R. Huh? What is R is your, some concentration, huh? What is that? Particle density, huh? Huh? Particle density or what is it? So right hand side Cp you know, Kn you know, B nu you know, this one is a flux, this thing, and therefore you can actually find out this mu bar is your secant 1 by secant 53. It is possible for you to calculate the dt by d tau of nu in the infrared part of the spectrum. This can also be done for, if you know kappa nu for each of these gases, you can do H2O, CO2, and then for the complete gas mixture of the atmosphere also we can do. Now we are not going to solve it. Somebody has already done the simplified form. In the next class, it's already late. In the next class, I will show you the vertical profiles. Okay.